Dear students, now we consider the test of significance approach developed independently by Fisher. Neyman and Pearson. Neyman and Pearson. A test of significance, as I told you earlier, is a procedure by which sample results are used to verify the truth or falsity of a null hypothesis. The key idea behind the test of significance approach is a test statistics and the sampling distribution of the test statistics under null hypothesis. The decision to accept or reject H0 is based on the value of the test statistics received from the sample at hand. Remember these sentences and hear these sentences again and again, these three sentences. Now, under the normality assumption, T is equal to beta 2 hat minus beta 2 by standard error of beta 2. It is the estimated standard error. As we have written earlier, beta 2 hat minus beta 2 root of sigma xi square by sigma hat, or sigma hat by root of sigma xi square. We have derived. I explain this test of significance approach as in the case of confidence interval approach using the T test statistics only, because in econometrics we will not use Z in this context because sigma is always replaced by sigma hat, and the standard errors given in the example are estimated standard errors. Now, if the value of beta 2 is specified under H0, if the value of beta 2 is specified under H0, remember this, then the T statistics can be calculated. Because standard error is given, the only unknown is beta 2. So if the value of beta 2 is specified under H0 as beta star 2 0.3, tested against not equal to 0.3, then T can be calculated. Then T can be used as the test statistics. T can be used as the test statistics. And our decision depends on the value of T obtained from the sample compared to critical T values. Now, as we have written earlier, probability that minus T alpha by 2 less than beta 2 hat minus beta star 2. That is the value of beta 2 specified on H0 by standard error of beta 2 hat less than T alpha by 2 is equal to 1 minus alpha. And this beta star 2 is the value of beta 2 specified under H0. T alpha by 2 is the critical T value for a given degrees of freedom and specified level of significance. In our example, it is 2.306. So I can give the value here as minus 2.306 plus 2.306. Because these are the critical T values in this specific example. Now this can be rearranged as probability that beta star 2 minus T alpha by 2 standard error of beta 2 hat less than beta 2 hat less than beta star 2 plus T alpha by 2 standard error of beta 2 hat is equal to 1 minus alpha. This is not the confidence interval. This is a different procedure. As I told you earlier, multiply throughout with the standard error of beta 2 hat and adding a beta star 2 on all the terms. You can rearrange this into this. Now, it is the interval in which beta 2 hat falls with the 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha probability given that beta 2 is equal to beta star. This is the interval in which beta 2 hat will fall with the probability 1 minus alpha, 95%. If beta star 2 is equal to beta star 2 specified under H0. And in the language of hypothesis testing, this 100 into 1 minus alpha percent, 100 into 1 minus alpha percent confidence interval is known as the region of acceptance of H0. And the outside, it is the region of rejection. Now, before explaining more, let us elaborate this example. We know that in our example, I first explain this in terms of beta 2 hat as earlier. This is beta 2 hat. This is 0.3, the value assumed under null hypothesis, and this is f of beta 2 hat. And if I calculate these values, beta star 2 minus t alpha by 2 plus etc. 0.3 plus or minus 2.306 into 0.0357. Not a confidence interval. Beta star 2 minus t plus t. That is this region. And this value is 0.3823. This is 0.2177. This is 95% of beta 2 hat. 95% of, or 0.95 of beta 2 hat lie in this interval. What I say is, if you take samples like this, a repeated number of times, you will generate a distribution. And if you plot the distribution like this, 95% of beta 2 hat lie between 0.2177 and 0.3823. And provided that the mean is 0.3. And this is not an actual distribution. Remember this, this is a hypothetical distribution. You will get to this distribution only after formulating H0. If H0 is not formulated, you cannot derive the t statistics. I mean, you will not get this distribution. So remember this, hypothesis testing is based on the sampling distribution of the estimator, not the actual sampling distribution, based on a hypothetical sampling distribution, based on an assumed parameter. That is, the parameter of beta 2 hat is beta 2. Now, this can be, we will not do this directly. We convert this unit of beta 2 hat into unit of t. When it is 0.3, this is 0. This is t distribution. And this is f of t. These are points which we have discussed in detail. Now, corresponding to this, this is 2.306. And this is corresponding to this, -2.306, and this is 0.95 or 95% of t. 95% of t for 8 degrees of freedom lie between -2.036 and +2.066. Now we calculate this t, beta 2 hat, 0.5091 minus 0.3 divided by 0.0357 is equal to the value of t in our example is 5.86. The value of beta 2 hat obtained is 0.5091 is here. When it is converted into t, it is 5.86. Now, in the test of significance approach, we compare the value obtained from the sample with the hypothesized value. If the value obtained from the sample is far away from the hypothesized value, it means our hypothesis may not be correct, or our sample may not be generated from a population with a hypothesized value equal to 0.3. So we have increasing suspicion about H0. So as the value of as the value of beta 2 hat is close to the hypothesized value, then close to hypothesized value, we will be in the acceptance region. Otherwise, we will be in the rejection region. So here the value obtained from the sample is far away from the hypothesized value. So we have suspicion about hypothesized value. What I say is, the probability that our sample is generated by a population with a mean equal to 0.3 is less than 5%, because 2.5% here, 2.5% here also, only a low probability, so we reject H0. When converted into t, our t value is 5.86. The probability of t equal to 5.86 is less than 5%. The actual probability will be discussed later. It is less than 5%, so again H0 is rejected. So as I told you, you can test a hypothesis using the estimator itself and its sampling distribution. But we will not do this. What we do is, we convert the estimator into a test statistics. And the test statistics is used for hypothesis testing. This is the procedure that we do. And as I told you earlier, if beta 2 hat is equal to beta star 2, then t will be equal to 0. T equal to 0 means somewhere here. Null hypothesis will be accepted. If estimated beta 2 is far away from hypothesized value, then what we say, large values is evidence against H0. Small values of t, evidence in favor of H0. Large values, evidence against. And to conclude, in the language of significance test, a test is said to be significant if the value of the test statistics lie in the critical region. If the value lie in the acceptance region, it is statistically insignificant. So in this example, as the value of the test statistics lie in the critical region, we will say that the test statistic is significant. Means the sample finding is significant, stated differently. The sample finding is significant. The test statistics is significant. And as we are using t-test here, we have a testing procedure based on t-tests. Now, you remember this? A statistical finding or a test statistics is said to be significant if and only if H0 is rejected. Otherwise, it is not a significant. If null hypothesis is not rejected, the test statistics is not a significant. And this is a two-tailed test. We can adopt a one-tailed test also. We can adopt a one-tailed test also if our null hypothesis is greater than 0.3, then the critical t value become 2, instead of 2.306, it becomes t is equal to 1.86. Then this will not be 2.306, it will be 1.86. So if you can take a one-tailed test, the critical value will be small. In the case of a two-tailed test, if the test statistic is here, null hypothesis will be, if the test statistic is here, using a two-tailed test, H0 is accepted, one-tailed rejected. So it increases the power of the test. If beta star 2 is less than type, we have a one-tailed test. Whether we have a two-tailed test, one-tailed test, or right-tailed or left-tailed, depends on the alternative hypothesis. And we will explain how we formulate various type of hypothesis later when we consider many examples. So to summarize, let me summarize what we have discussed so far. Now, H0, H1, reject H0 if two tail. H0, beta 2 is equal to beta star 2, beta 2 not equal to beta star 2, absolute value of t, negative or positive, greater than t alpha by 2 for given degrees of freedom, as we have stated here. Then right tail, beta 2, less than or equal to beta star 2, beta 2 greater than beta star 2, and t greater than t alpha for given degrees of freedom, one-tailed t, alpha in one side, 5% in one side only, left tail, beta 2 greater than or equal to beta star 2, beta 2 less than beta star 2, then t is less than minus t alpha by 2 for degrees of freedom. Consider these points as a summary. In the first case, two-tailed. In the second and third cases, one-tailed. And we will consider later different types of hypotheses we will fix in the real world. And let me say one more point regarding hypothesis testing. Always remember that for hypothesis testing, we use the sampling distribution. And the area of the sampling distribution is divided into two, highly likely and unlikely under H0. Highly likely values are close to hypothesized values. Unlikely, far away from this. Also remember this. This is a hypothetical distribution. If you give a different distribution, say for example, instead of 0.3, if it was 0.5, then this will be in the acceptance region, not in the rejection region. So it is important to fix a hypothesis first. Otherwise, once you obtain the result, and if you fix a hypothesis after observing the results, you can always reject H0. That practice is not is not recommended. Fix the hypothesis first, then collect the data, estimate the parameters, then using the distribution, the sampling distribution. Remember this, sampling distribution is not directly used. We use test statistics derived from the sampling distribution. And also remember this, the sampling distribution of test statistics depends on the normality assumption. So normality assumption of the estimator is important. And in the regression context, normality of the estimator depends on normality of U. It has nothing to do with dependent variable or independent variable. Also, this normality assumption is important if and only if the sample size is small. If you have a sufficiently large sample size, normality assumption is not very important. That is, provided that n is greater than 100, for example, normality assumption is not very important. Now, this is the essence of hypothesis testing, but there are many other issues associated with hypothesis testing, and these issues will be discussed in the next class. That is, some practical issues associated with the hypothesis testing. And to get a firm grip on hypothesis testing, I recommend that you read the examples given in standard books and the interpretations given and the like. Then only your understanding of this estimation, hypothesis testing, interpretation of the results, etc., will become more familiar to you.